welcome to Neutral Side Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bowling Green has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. It's fielded at the 2. At the 30. Across midfield. And they finally make the stop at the 36-yard line.
He came close to taking that one all the way. Still, this is a fantastic way to start things off.
So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in there.
And down he goes, right around the 2-yard line. Touchdown, Golden Eagles.
That is great, tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
And he hits the PAT. So a short three-play, 37-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 7-0. Southern Miss kicked this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. To about the 41-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Second and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Fights forward to about the 43. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's at the 40. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 30.
If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 20. That's a great tackle at the 37-yard line.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
Southern Miss is up a score. Got a man open, bad pass. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39-yard line. Steps out of bounds at about the 49. Excellent open field tackle.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's taken down at the 28. From the 29-yard line, second down. Tackle at the 30.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instinct.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Southern Miss up 7 points. He steps up. They'll bring him down at the 13. He might not be able to get the pass off. And he is drilled at the 21-yard line.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you're definitely going to feel it the next day.
This is the 10th play of this drive. He's into the open field. Good outside run there. 6 yards there on the option keeper. The ball pops free. Scoops up the loose ball. And they hit him in the backfield. The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Southern Miss is hoping to make this a two-score game. It's up. And it's good. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Their last drive resulted in a punt, so let's see if they can put together something a little more promising here.
They've been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Has some daylight. He's tackled at the 35.
2-6.
Hands off to the left, and they wrestle him down behind the line. Throws this one away. They're going to be forced to punt it away here.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
Brought down at the 35-yard line. The Golden Eagles are having their way on offense so far in this football game.
Just a nice rhythm to what they're trying to do. It's a balanced attack, running and throwing, and right now this defense just can't stop it.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. And they push him out at the 44-yard line. Tackled around the 43-yard line. Here's the halfback. And they make the stop at about the 43-yard line. And we've reached the end of one. Golden Eagles with a 10-point lead. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. He gets rid of this one. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Steps up in the pocket. He's wrapped up for the sack. From their own 18-yard line. Second down. They give to the tailback. Tackle made around the 28-yard line. Pulls in the pass and steps out.
The offense gets a first down here. You got to give them some credit. But really, this is more about the defense. When a defense gets an offense to third down and medium, you've got to be able to put pressure on a quarterback, especially when they're passing the football, and try to get your own offense the ball back. And that time, they let their own offense down.
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And they got him for a loss. Drop back a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Short over the middle. He's taken down at the 34-yard line. As a man, he'll lose big yards. That's a loss of 4 yards.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
He really got a hold of that one. And he's tackled at the 28-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. They go with a run. Runs it left for a decent gain. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Looks for his time over the middle. And down he goes at about the 35. Fires that quickly, incomplete. So that'll make it fourth down.
Yeah, they just couldn't connect on the pass there. That was a very good stand by this defense.
Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Room around the corner. He's tackled at the 40-yard line. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. The 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, second down. Big opening. Makes it out to about the 40.
You talk about a dual-threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Dangerous throw. This one's picked off.
The defense here comes up with a huge interception. They've already got the lead, and it looked like this offense was trying to get back in the game, but that was a big turnover.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Five wide. Throws and it's incomplete.
He threw that ball so hard, I don't think anybody wanted to catch it.
It's third and 10. Ball on their own 38. It all going deep and got him, and he's taken down at the 21. He throws right, throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. So a 4-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. Southern Miss yet set to kick this one away. Excellent kick. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 24.
I think I can count on one hand the last time I saw this good a defensive performance where you had a chance for a shutout. Are you kidding me? In college football today, with the spread and the running quarterbacks and all the speed in space, these guys got a chance to put up a shutout.
It's still only the second quarter. We've got a lot of football left, but I've got to say, this one is teetering on the brink of the blowout. Out of bounds at the 27. From their own 27-yard line, it's second down.
Showing a lot of confidence in this running back. Here's third down and medium. In some cases, you might be thinking that the offense would want to pass, but instead they give it to their back, and he shows that they're not wrong in being able to pick up that first down.
Strike to his receiver, no good. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down.
Well, the defensive line has to do a better job there of feeling that screen out. And a lot of times the offensive line will dictate whether or not it is going to be a screen pass or not. When they feel and sense the offensive lineman releasing out to get out in front of the screen and to be able to try to make a play downfield, again, the defensive line is the key for any defense in being able to slow down a screen pass.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Complete. He's hit right away. Passes to his tailback again. Nice play to set up first and goal.
That's the third time they've converted on third down on this drive. When you can stay on the field in these kind of situations, you're doing something right.
Let it go, and it's caught for the touchdown. Converts the extra point. We've still got a half of football remaining. The Golden Eagles with a 10-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. This team's now got a hill to climb in the second half. We anticipated it being a tight game, but as you watched this team late in the half, you started to see guys looking for answers. You could almost sense it. They were looking at who's going to take ownership, who's going to lead and make a play. Somebody has to step up right now, David.
Yeah, no doubt about it. When you come into games, you feel like you have this huge game plan and all this stuff you want to accomplish, and sometimes it doesn't work. And sometimes you got to start changing things around, and sometimes it's simple. Sometimes the quarterback needs to come in the huddle and say, hey, guys, y'all want to protect me a little better? You know, they need to say some things that, that makes people feel uncomfortable sometimes to get a rise out of them and knowing your team. Sometimes middle linebackers have to get the defense all in tight and say, listen, you need to make sure you're taking care of this. They've been killing us on this route. It's your fault. Step up. The leaders in the huddle a lot of times can say the things that the coaches can't and get a different reaction.
Well, maybe it's time I say something to you, too. It's time for you to pick up your game at halftime. David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Here he goes. And he hauls that one in. He's knocked out of bounds at the 30. Nice run up the middle. Nice run, and he's brought down. They'll bring him down around the 40-yard line. He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
That makes it 37.
It's third down and 7 to go. Ball on the 40. Some room and a quick throw. He's tackled at the 47.
That makes it first and 10.
Here's a running play, and he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That's a D4. That brings him 65.
Tackled around the 37-yard line. Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete. From the 37-yard line. Second down. Fires out quickly to the tailback. And they make the stop at the 27-yard line. First down, Gray. And he shoved out of bounds around the 15-yard line.
That's a D12 on the play. First down.
They'll drop him for a loss.
I think the corner is the toughest position to play in football. You have to be athletic enough to be able to run with wide receivers and willing to be able to come up and make plays like this to be able to stop the run. This is a big-time play by a corner, showing the versatility to be able to come up and be physical in the run game.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That makes it 37.
tracks with that tackle.
Well, that's one of those plays where the wide receiver is expected to make something happen after the reception, but the defense wasn't giving up anything.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. Across the 30. The 50. Inside the 30. For the 10. Touchdown, Southern Miss.
Wow, what a return for a touchdown. That kind of burst and escapability is so rare and so much fun to watch.
And he hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 25. The Falcons really had a tough first half. I got to give them credit for hanging in there and turning things around here in the third quarter.
You're right, Brad. They could have just shut it down as bad as they looked in the first half. But great perseverance by the entire offensive unit. It's paid off. Back-to-back drives now. They've got points up on it.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He gets to about the 41-yard line. He fights forward to about the 43. And he hits him hard at the 45-yard line. Made right around the 42-yard line. There's a little bit of happy feet down there on the field. Let's get the call.
False start. Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
Still second down.
From the 47-yard line, second down. Taken down at the 37-yard line. The halfback option gets him 10 yards down the field.
That'll bring up 32.
It's the sophomore that's got it. And down he goes around the 23-yard line. Strike to the receiver, and he's taken down at the 13. Goes to the end zone. They knock it down, incomplete. And that one was oh so close.
Close call is right. If he just put a little bit more touch on the ball, that would have been a big play. But let's give credit to the linebacker. That was an athletic play there by the defense.
And they got to him before he could get back to the line.
Good, solid defense there to force him into a fourth down situation.
Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They put everyone up on the line. Fires quickly, touchdown! just like they draw it up, Kirk.
Yeah, Brad, you're exactly right. Offensive line did a good job of protecting the quarterback. Good route by the receivers. Results, touchdown.
So they go to the air on fourth down when they needed a big play, and boy, do they come through. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Let's see if they decide to kick it to him again. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. Kirk, not sure what went out in the locker room at halftime, but both offenses have really come ready to play in the third quarter.
I think that's really what separates a good team from a great team, is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and come out and being able to execute. So far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that.
We're about set to start things up again. Southern Miss is up a score. Final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. Golden Eagles with a touchdown lead. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Gets it out quickly to the back, but he can't haul it in. It's third down, 12 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. He's hit and taken down. The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. Tries to get around the corner. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Gets it out quickly. Brought down at the 50. Makes it to the 41.
That brings in second and one.
Throws incomplete.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Quick pass, tackled right around the 40. Setting up play action. Throws to the tailback. Incomplete. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. They come out in a five-wide set. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 13. Looks to the end zone and is caught. Touchdown. The extra point to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Don't be surprised if they don't kick the ball to this guy again. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And you know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. Snags it complete out of bounds, though, and they're going to lose yardage. Just under three to go in regulation. And they get nice yardage on that run. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they push him out at about the 43-yard line. Complete. He's got room. They'll bring him down at the 50-yard line. Tackled at the 42-yard line. Zips it to the back, and he's tackled around the 30-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Throws it in a hurry, and they make the stop at the 24-yard line. Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. He throws it. Fourth down. It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. He gets it up, and it's long enough, and it's good. Southern Miss, ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the three. Tackle made at the 26. The Falcons have put up 24 unanswered points. One team can't do anything wrong, the other team can't do anything right. This is what you dream about, situations like this. You've got the football, you're behind, but if you take the lead, it could mean a win. He's going to try and scramble. He's got an opening. Get down, get down. incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38. Under a minute left in the game. And they get the sack. Bowling Green's going to use their first time out of the half here. Here's the halfback on the screen. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He guns it to the left. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him on a first and goal. And he throws it away. This is the ninth play of this drive. Tackle made at the one. Incomplete, and that wasn't the greatest pass in the world.
Well, I don't know how anybody can throw a great pass while getting drilled like that.
This game now lies squarely on the shoulders of this kicker. If he misses, then this game is all but over. A make, and we're looking at overtime. The kick is away, and it's good. Smart for these guys to kick away from that dangerous return man. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. And down he goes, the 25-yard line. It's been a good one so far today. Let's see what happens here.
The worst thing that should happen for the offense now is that the game will go into overtime. If they can make a couple of plays, then maybe they'll pull it out in regulation.
There's the strike complete. He's taken down around the 36-yard line. The Golden Eagles taking their first time out of the half. From their own 36-yard line. First down. Quick toss. Got it to the senior. And he is drilled at the 36. What a great play.
This is the timing that we talked about in the pregame that they must have in order to be successful at their passing game. That time the quarterback threw it to a spot, and his receiver was there to make a nice grab.
We're going to overtime. That'll do it for regulation, and we are going to settle this one in overtime. Well, we played an hour, and it's still not enough. We're set to kick off here in overtime. Throws it out right to the running back. Has some daylight. Touchdown, Falcons. Makes the PAT. First and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. And an open touchdown. So they come up with the equalizer.
This offense did just what they had to do. They knew they needed 6 points, and they got it. That was just a great series.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT.
Well, this is why I love the overtime rules in college football. Both teams had a fair shot at it, and they'll get another opportunity to try it again.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Good open field tackle. That gives him 100 yards in the game.
I think the quarterback and this receiver right now are clearly in the zone. The defense needs to do a better job of adjusting their defense to be able to slow him down. He now has over 100 yards receiving in this game.
He throws a dart to the left. Hit immediately. He's got it out to his tight end. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Ball inside the 10-yard line. It's third down. He's got it with room to run. Touchdown, Golden Eagles. So the offense steps up and gets a big 6 points here in double overtime.
And that gives them some breathing room for the time being. But I'll tell you, the way this game is being played, I wouldn't be surprised if we saw this offense on the field again in a third overtime.
And he adds the extra point. From the 25-yard line, it's first down, five wide. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And down he goes at the 15-yard line.
Second and inches.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down.
There we go, 30 seconds.
Slings it. And he's taken down around the 4-yard line. Second down, goal to go. Ball on the two. Got his receiver, touchdown. We'll be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point.
This has been one of those games where everything seems to hang in the balance on each play. Whatever the outcome is, we'll remember this one for a long time.
And he might want it all here, and does!
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Zips it to the tight end. Tackle right around the 14-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Now he tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down around the 13-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
From the 13-yard line, it's second down. Left, picked off. first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line. Big play, and it's first and goal.
Finish, and tons of credit to the defenders for keeping them off the board in that first series. These guys looked loose and ready to grab this one, and that's exactly what they did.
A great one to win, a really tough one to lose. Southern Miss, 47, Bowling Green, 41. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.